My name is Encarnacion. My great-grandmother named me, and my grandmother and I have always loved my name very much. As a matter of fact, I am the fourth one in my family with the name. But as much as I love the name, what I don't like is people asking, what kind of a name is that? And what can I call you for short? I tell them about the history of my name. There is a church in Madrid, Spain called Santa Encarnacion. Encarnacion is the patron saint for birthing mothers. There is also a school and a playground in Madrid, Spain, named after the saint. So when people ask me again about my name, I tell them about the saint. I tell them if they are going to call me anything for short or for whatever, they are going to have to call me Encarnacion, whether they like it or not, because that is my name. That essay was written by my mom when she was 74 years old. The reason it's special for me is because she learned to read and write after the age of 72. My mom is now 89 years old. 3 years ago, so it's about, she was living by herself and she seemed to be doing okay. And when I visited her, there were times when she seemed to be forgetful, and then there were times when she kept asking the same question over and over. But she still was able to manage by herself. But now, and I know I was in self-denial, because my mom has Alzheimer's. When I go to visit my mom at the nursing home, I don't know whether to cry or to be happy. To cry because I've lost someone very close to me, that just about close, because I cannot communicate with her. I cannot confide in her the way I used to the many years that we lived together. And I can't share the many things that I want to share with her. But then I think maybe it's not so bad in the state that she's in, because when I look into her eyes, she seems to have a peace within her that she doesn't worry. She has no worries. Her health is very good. So she really isn't suffering in it, in that sense of the word. My mom was a very active and strong-willed person. And I remember her telling me, you can do anything you want. You have to work at it, but you can do it. And I know that for a fact because after 20 years of smoking, she decided one day she was never not going to smoke again. And overnight, she just stopped smoking. And I have a little essay that she wrote. She calls it, Look Again. After 3 weeks of traveling through California and Mexico and seeing all the signs warning people not to smoke because it is dangerous to your health, I returned to sophisticated New York while taking my usual walk along the avenue. I saw a big sign advertising Virginia Slim cigarettes. In the sign are 5 well-dressed young women, all smiling and happy, each with a cigarette in their hand. On the sign in large letters is written, You came a long way, baby. A long way to what? To being equal to men in lung cancer and emphysema? Women trying to be equal to men is one thing. But if all we have to show for our fight for equality is a cigarette, please give me a break. My mom was very active as well. I remember I visited her in New York and her routine was to go to the gym 20 blocks away and she would walk there and walk back. And this was whether it was raining, sleet, snow, or hot. Monday through Saturday, she would go to her exercise class and walk there as well. And when I visited her in New York, we would walk all over Central Park. And then on several trips that we took to Europe, we walked all over Europe. And I have some pictures of that. Here we are on the different trips. We went to Rome, the Fountain of Trevi. We went to Venice, naturally, and she just loved the United States and America. And there she is, Miss Liberty. Here she is on her many trips to, naturally one of her favorite things to do, gamble at the casinos in Atlantic City and in Las Vegas. And she did love to dance as well. And there she is, giving it a try, giving it her best. With her hats on, just about every picture we have her in. And there she is, exemplifying the, which says, I'm a woman of the 90s, independent woman of the 90s. No one in my family has lived past 82, and those that passed away did not show any signs of Alzheimer's. This is a new sickness to me. I've read up on it, and I've seen enough of the suffering that goes with it. It's a deteriorating sickness, and it's kind of sad to see the people that you love so much to go that way. It's kind of sad when you see that you can't talk to your mother the way you used to. And when you see some of the people in the facility, some who never get any visitors because, well, for one thing, so many of their friends have already passed away. This is an exhaustive and depressing illness. But the one thing I have to say, I still have my mom's pictures and I have many more of the good times that we shared. I have the experiences that we also had. And also I have her essays that tell a lot about how she was thinking, how she thought, and how she felt. This one she calls 75 is just a number. People ask me how old I am. I tell them I'm 75 years old. And their answer is, you don't look 75. You look maybe 50 or 60. If I say that I am 50, they say, oh, well, you could pass for 40 years old anytime. Whether I am 75 or 60 or 50 or even passing for 40, I learned that 75 is just another number. And who is to say what a person of 75 should look like? I like that. And this last one, it leaves me with a great advice from her. It's called Making Life Easier. Sometimes I feel like the whole world belongs to me alone. I think that is because I look at the world differently than most people. There are times when I'm walking on the street and meet some of my friends. They ask me how I am. And when I say that I'm okay, they tell me that nothing seems to bother me. And I always seem to be okay. I feel like telling them that if they accept life as it is, with its good times and its bad times, that they will be okay too. Sometimes by not minding your own business, you get mixed up with other people's problems. And by trying to help them, you only prevent them from solving their own problems and learning from their experience. We can do very little about changing the world. If there's any changes to be made, we will have to make them in ourselves. This way, life will be much easier to live. I hope and pray that they do find a cure for Alzheimer's. It's a terrible disease. And I just miss my mom so much. I also hope that Lady Alzheimer's, as I call her, doesn't come knocking at my door.